Alright guys, today we're going to be making a video on this Armor All Ceramic Wheel Cleaner. So this is kind of a follow-up video to the ceramic wash video. Same car, same time. We're going to be trying this product out. So pretty much what this product is pretty much take the soap that we used on the paint and pretty much turn it into a wheel cleaner. So kind of just go over it real quick. Obviously you're going to shake it, and you can either have it on a dry cool surface or a wet cool surface. It just has to be kind of cool surface. So up to you. We're probably going to do wet on this one because kind of just help maybe spread it when this stuff sprays. You're actually just going to spray the tire with it, or the rim and the tire, and you're just going to let it sit for a few minutes. It says up to like 3 to 5 minutes for heavily contaminated surfaces. So maybe on the inside, if you spray in there and stuff like that, and then you'll agitate it with brushes. And if you're detailing, probably commonly probably have a bunch of different wheel brushes that you'll use on your rims and tires. And then once you do that, you'll thoroughly rinse it off, and then you'll actually spray it on there again to coat it, to actually give it that protection, and then rinse it off, and then you can dry it.
That's pretty cool.
So it's almost like a wax, a spray wax, but it also is a built-in cleaner, which saves
some
time.
I didn't know it did that. Yeah, we can.
So I'm gonna spray this rim off pretty good, and then actually use this product on it. So I'm gonna start spraying, kind of clean it up a little bit.
Pretty much on any product, I would rather spray your wheel and tire and then use your wheel cleaner and tire cleaner.
Yeah, this helps kind of knock a lot of that
dirt.
Big dirt or anything that might lightly come off.
Yeah, because I know most of you guys may have some, you know, expensive wheels on your vehicles. And so, you don't want to mess them up, that's for sure.
So here I'm going to spray this on there.
That spray's nice, I like that.
Yep, so it says you can let it sit longer, up to 3 and 5 minutes.
You want to spray inside the barrel too?
About 2 minutes for light contamination. So for the most part, we're going to go with about 2 to 3 minutes.
Yeah, we'll let it sit a couple minutes and see what it looks like. And now if it's really hot out, of course it's going to dry a little bit faster. You're going to have to work faster. So today, our weather in Michigan, it's October, where it's cool out, it's cloudy today. So that kind of helps us where we can take our time and really detail a vehicle. But if it's real hot in the middle of summer, yeah, of course you're not going to want it to dry. Because you know you guys ever use a product, you're trying to do wheels, and you're trying to, you know, clean the tire, and then the stuff that's on the wheel is already starting to dry, and you got to recoat it. So stuff like that.
So here's some of the brushes we use. These are probably my personal favorites to use. So this one is really nice for the tires. It's kind of soft, but not too soft, where it will actually get a lot of this dirt off of the tire. I like to use one of these horsehair brushes. This one's a little cut down, but it's nice to be able to get inside the lug nuts or any of these maybe tight corners. And that's what these two also are nice for. This one, the big one, is really nice to be able to get inside the inside of the rim. And then this one's just nice to kind of use for all over the front of it. So we have a lot more brushes, and we have a whole bunch. We have stuff like this. So if you have a car with maybe hard to reach rims like this, or you have a nice set of custom rims, definitely invest in getting some really good brushes, something that are going to really help you keep them clean and keep them from getting scratched up.
We'll have some links below so you can get products like this too from Amazon, and basically we can make a little bit of money from the Amazon if you use the links, and we'll appreciate it, and we can buy more products too.
All right guys,
I'm gonna respray it. It's been a few minutes, pretty much dried up. All right, let's go, let's get it cleaned up.
I would say rims are probably one of the hardest things to actually clean on a lot of these cars, so if having the right brushes definitely helps, but also having the right products. We've been using an assortment of different products.
Look at that dirt out
there. They're all pretty good, but it's pretty cool to see one that's going to help have a protection. So if you have these nice painted kind of rims on there, this will leave a nice protection on the paint and hopefully keep a lot of this brake grime and all that stuff actually off of your painted rims.
Get in there like that. That helps get in there. Honestly, to me, man, I hate cleaning wheels. How about you guys? It's one of those things, it's just a pain. And sometimes you just gotta go over them a few times to get them really clean. That's my opinion, though. What do you guys think? Get in here, try to get it cleaned up. Then we got our tire brush. Clean it up. Not a tire, you just need to knock off your old. Don't have to be spotless. You just want to knock off your old dressing out here. A little bit of dirt, and it's done. I mean, tires, you can spend hours trying to clean it. That's it, and then let's rinse her off. That's pretty neat that it's beating. Show these guys, show them the beating of it.
It's pretty crazy. Gave it a nice shine, too. That's crazy. Show them the back wheel.
So that is cleaned, and obviously this one will be unclean. So you see quite a difference there.
Dang, it gave it a nice shine. Huh. Look at that, guys. That's pretty sweet.
Now, for the final step with this product, you're actually going to spray it on and let it sit for 1 minute, and then just rinse it off, and then you'll dry the rim. So here we are. We're just going to spray it on the front of it, the painted surface. You just let it sit for about a minute, and then you'll just rinse it off thoroughly, and then you'll be able to dry your rims and be all set. Okay, guys. So we let it sit for a minute. That's how long it says on the final step. Let it sit. So we're going to rinse it off, and then we'll be able to dry it off.
We're gonna dry it off. We'll show you guys drying off, and then we're gonna end up cleaning the rest of the wheels, and then show you guys the final results and our final thoughts on the product. It's a product you guys can get at the store. So far, I'm liking it. Who knows how long it's gonna last for protection, but if you use it once a month,
you'll always have it. Dry this rim off. So we're kind of using an older towel we have. We don't really like to use our brand new expensive towels on our rims and then transfer it to the paint. So if you can, if you have the option to, try to have a designated set of towels just for rims and have a nice set of designated towels for your paint.
Yeah, you definitely want to. It's good advice what you just said, pretty much.
All right, as you guys can see, really shiny. I mean, it really did give it a nice shine, and you could tell it gave it a nice slick surface. Feels like it gave it a decent amount of protection.
Wow,
there,
that is shiny.
And
dang, that is pretty dang good. Another thing too is, you if you have one of those air cannons, you can blow out your lug nuts. We didn't get ours out today.
Yeah, but as you guys can see, it did a lot of good, has a lot of good cleaning power. And then what's nice is it has a lot of that cleaning power, but then it also still has a lot of that protection. I mean, this is very smooth for being a rim. And obviously, I mean, these are, your rims get abused probably the most on any part of the car that you need to clean. So
pretty good.
That's great to see that.
Here's the dirty one. And that's the final one there.
So far, it looks good, guys. All right, we'll clean the rest of the them up, and we'll show the products. Dang, that paint is smooth. Alright guys, all the wheels are done. You can see how clean they are. We got the dog crying in the background. Next up too, it's gonna be the tire ceramic coating right here. This basically repels dirt. And then what you do is you basically spray it on, let it to dry a few minutes, and then you can recoat it if you want a better shine. This is a medium shine. And it says too also to let it dry for about an hour before you drive your vehicle. All right, let's spray it up and see what how it goes. I like how it sprays. Plus two, it says let a few minutes and you can go back and hit the spots you may have missed. Drive the vehicle and hit the other side. Looks pretty good, guys. All right, see how dirty that is. These tires haven't been done in a while. It's got a different smell to this. It smells almost, I don't know, kind of hard to say. It gives it a good shine. We'll let it dry as it dries. Plus, you can put on your plastics right on there. I did the other side to protect the soap. I pretty much did the other side to test it. Look at the difference. Check that out. It's pretty good, guys. And you can see it right there. You don't need a lot. Put on your microfiber towel. This is a towel we don't use for paint. And plus two, if you wanted to, you can always spray in here. Get your lip in there. And then any excess you have, just wipe it off. And then wipe off your wheels, and you're good to go. All right, we'll let it dry, and then we'll see what it looks like, and I'll continue to do the trim. All right, guys, we got the tire sign on there. It's been close to about an hour. Let's give a nice shine. I mean, it's pretty glossy, guys, actually. I wish the sun was out a little bit more to show you. It looks like it's still drying, but it's cooler out too, so it would dry faster if it was a little bit hotter out, but I would wait in cooler weather, maybe an hour or two. You can always wipe out the excess if you want a lighter. It's kind of sticky, though. Coming off, so you gotta really get in there. Kind of drags. So there you go. That's what it looks like when you dry it off. Like a microfiber towel. See the difference from that one to this one. That's the what you'll get, guys. All right, I think it worked out pretty good with the wheel cleaner and tire cleaner and the tire dressing ceramic. Came out great, guys. So if you guys use this, let us know if you guys use these two products or just one of them, and if you plan on using it, and let us know your experience with them. And thanks for watching this one, and don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment, and check out some of our old videos. I'd like to see you guys there. All right, guys, you guys have a good one. Later.